What's going on, folks? It's me,
Mikey Pipes.
Friday, love me Fridays. Friday, July 11th, 2025. It is a little almost 7:20 here in the morning in the great state of New York. Heading to my first service call of the day in Rockaway, Far Rockaway, sorry, 11691 zip code. We have an existing residential client whose central air conditioning system is on the fritz. They called literally at 6:15 this morning on the emergency service line, got my AI dispatcher on the phone. That's right, folks. I have an artificial intelligence dispatcher. If you want information, email me, mike@mikeypipes.com. I'll tell you how to set it up. Very, 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 very cheap. Anyway, system is turning on and off according to the dispatcher, and they requested emergency service. I called them moments later, and we're in route. I got my bagel from the bagelery, and I got an iced tea. One sugar. Let's go take care.
All right, house call pro. Start my time. Bingo.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah. How are you? Nice to see you again.
You as well. What's going on?
Here's the deal. We were out for a few days. It was working okay, but not great. So when we came back, I didn't notice that it was set at 75 degrees. It did not reach 75 degrees, it was 78 degrees.
Okay.
Sitting there, and the unit is like, so I went to bed because we came in late. Then I heard the unit is on off.
Outdoor unit?
Yeah.
Oh.
And it's not cooling the place down, so I let it run for about 10 hours. It couldn't hit.
With it turning on off like that?
Yeah. No. I did not do that. What I did is I shut it off.
Okay.
When I came, I shut it off. So yes. I figured because you told me the last time you came was the capacitor was gonna go.
Okay.
So I changed the capacitor. It runs about 9 hours, still couldn't cool the place down, and then it started again, on off, that's it.
So it's turning on off rapidly?
Yes.
Okay, let's go see the unit. Okay. And it's not cooling the place well?
No.
All right, let me get a couple tools and we'll check the pressures of the system out. Right now it's running.
Yeah.
So, okay, let's see.
All right, we have the JB probes climate class hooked up to low side, high side, temperature. And we are very low on refrigerant, 1 degree of subcooling.
Yes.
Very low.
Low. Yeah. You know, this is, let's see. This is a 4-ton system, came charged with 7 pounds, 8 ounces, probably another pound maybe that it took, so maybe around 8.5 pounds of total charge, but it's low on refrigerant, means you have, it went somewhere.
Okay.
It doesn't get used, right. Doesn't like gas in a car or need to be changed like oil in an engine.
Right.
That means you have a leak or someone took it out.
Yeah.
And there's 5 things you can do. You ready to hear the 5 things you can do?
Uh-huh.
We could do nothing.
Okay.
If we do nothing, obviously it's gonna stay operating the same way it has been.
Right.
The on and off,
yeah.
turning on, compressor runs for a brief amount of time, turns off.
Yeah.
That is usually an issue with the pressure switch.
Right.
Not an issue with the pressure, that is usually the pressure switch sensing there's not enough pressure in the system, so it turns the system off.
Right.
Why it's not doing it now? That's a good question.
Right.
Maybe the coil was frozen. Maybe, I don't know how long this has been running. How long has it been running now for?
No, now, just turned it on this morning.
Okay. Yeah. So, it could have been a frozen condition across the coil. System froze up, but
It is low on refrigerants. Number one, you could do nothing. Number two, we can gas and go. I give you more gas and I go. It's 175 a pound, and it's like a blood transfusion without getting stitched up.
All right.
So it will.
Is there a way you could pressure test it to know if it's leaking?
Well, I'm getting there.
Okay.
All right. Number three, we can add refrigerant and add a sealant to the system with an ultraviolet dye.
Okay.
To A, try to help seal up the leak. Right. There's no warranty or guarantee on that.
Right.
And number two, gives us something to look for, something easy to look for when we come back for a leak search.
Okay.
Number four, we do a leak search.
Okay.
And there's several different types, but the system would be isolated. There's three major components. We have an outdoor unit, we have an indoor unit, we have copper lines.
Yeah.
We would suck out all the refrigerant that you have, that's one option, and separate the system and pressurize each component individually.
Okay, because the condenser was leaking before originally, when it was brand new.
Okay.
So they had to change that.
Okay.
They put in a new condenser and it works okay. The people who did
How old's the unit?
I think about 15 years.
Okay, so there's no warranty anymore. You're not going to do a leak search because you're going to spend $1,000 minimum just for a leak search for me to tell you where the leak is.
Right.
And then let's say it's a leak that can be fixed, it's thousands of dollars more.
All right.
You're going to end up replacing the system because of the age.
Okay, so.
And then number five, you replace the system.
Yeah, okay. All right, let me ask you something. When you say replace the system, the whole system?
The indoor unit and the outdoor unit.
Now, what will that run?
In the teens.
But I don't think I need a 4-ton system. Isn't this thing too big for this house?
I haven't done that kind of measurement yet.
No?
If we go that route, we would do a quick measurement of the house to see what you need. But 4 tons, for a 2,000 square foot house, built in the 70s and 60s, is with no insulation upgrades is okay.
Right,
but
if
this house has newer windows, is insulated well, has good insulation in the attic, the ductwork is good, you may need a 2.5 ton. Tons for this size house seems a little excessive. It's a ranch.
Yeah.
I'm not disrespecting your house. It's not a large home, but it's not a tiny house either.
Right.
But 3-4 tons may seem excessive. It seems like whoever sold you this.
So if you do the sealant and refill.
Okay.
And let's see what happens.
Okay, no problem.
You heard the man. Gas and go with the sealant. So that's my, kind of light here, and my easy seal. I love this stuff, by the way. Link in the description box down below. All right, let's start with a pound, see what happens.
I think I already asked this, but the filter's clean.
Okay.
And the air coming out of the vents is nice and strong. Okay. Okay, very good.
Let's go to 2. It may just be a couple of pounds here. Pressure is much better on that low side. Still sitting around 4 degrees subcooling. I have ants everywhere.
There's a million ants here.
Ants?
Yeah. They're like on a mission.
Yeah, there's a lot of ants.
Yeah. I hope I don't come home with any.
Outdoor ambient is 75 degrees, 77% humidity.
Right. 61.5 degrees and 58% humidity. 61.5. And the return at 73.5 degrees.
Could be better. Especially considering it's a 4-ton system. Yeah, they got them for the healthy home. So a furnace with the coil. Hmm. He wasn't joking about the filter. It is clean. How about our panel? Let me try something here. There's no lights on this thing. This thing is burnt out. Let's see if there's a difference of airflow. No, much better. Yeah, 85 degree condensed discharge temperature. And 8.5 degrees subcool. Hot and humid, folks. 100% humidity. Even though it's 75 degrees out, it's hot and humid. All right, ladies and gentlemen. 3 pounds of R410A with some sealant. Got it subcooling to 8.5. I would have probably given him more, but my 410A tank went empty. It went empty, keeping it real. Could I have added more? Yeah, but you know what? The design subcooling was plus or minus 2 degrees at 10 degrees of subcooling on the rating plate. 8.5, we're good. But I did tell him that if the system isn't cooling a degree an hour off the home, give us a call, we'll add a little bit more. I'd rather be cautious than overcharge and have other system operational problems. So it is what it is, keeping it real. Just keeping it real, folks. And that's what you should do. Keep it real with your end user, the client, the homeowner, the consumer, the customer. Thank you so much for watching. If you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area, and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor, I want you to pick up the phone and give us a call. We're licensed and insured on Long Island and in New York City, as well as the states of South Carolina and Florida. Give us a call. We'd love to help you. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe.